Yo, what's good, Griffin13 here back in today, and today, guys, we are here for another Horizon Top 5s. This is the series where I go over some very interesting cars that I would like to see come to Forza Horizon 4. And what we're going to be doing today, last week we did trucks, this week we are doing everyday boring sedan. So this one was probably the number one most requested. They wanted everyday cars, where I'm going to break it out, so we're going to have everyday sedans. Gonna have everyday coupes. We might have a classic version later on down the line, but what I'm gonna be going with today, because everyday cars, I decided to go with some more modern choices, so that's what we're gonna go ahead and stick with today. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get on into it. So starting things off, coming in at number five, what we have is the 2012 Kia Optima. Now, this was the first year that the Optima name was actually used across the entire globe. Before that, it had some other names. It was always Optima here in the United States. It had different names over in Europe. It was called like the K5 over in Korea where it's built. You know, it was just had some different names. But I've always thought that this car looked a little bit more sporty than it actually was. It had 274 horsepower as an option here in North America from a 2-liter turbocharged engine. The thing is, though, is most people didn't get that because when you go and buy a Kia Optima, you're not really thinking about how sporty it is. It was a front-wheel drive sedan. I had a friend who had one of these, and honestly, his was dope because it came in this nice blue color, had yellow headlights on it, and I kept trying to convince him to, you know, go get some bronze wheels, make it look kind of like a Subaru. Honestly, I love the way these cars look. I feel like they were always a little bit more aggressive looking than they really should, like I said earlier. And I love them. I really do. Except for the fact that it's a Kia, because it's going to break down on you. In fact, he bought his Kia and literally, like, he literally drove it from Florida to Ohio. And on the way back, what ended up happening was the car broke down. The engine seized on him in the middle of the highway. It had 30,000 miles on it. It was basically a brand new car. And the engine seized on it. And then Kia tried to, you know, swindle him and said, and it's going to be about $7,000 for a new engine. And then he's like, I don't think so. I'm going to get my lawyer involved. And they're like, oh, wait, we got a discount. We'll take half the price off. So now it's only a $3,500 engine. He's like, I'll be back. And he came back with his lawyer. And they said, oh, wow, it's covered by warranty. It's free. So he ended up getting a free engine replacement out of it. But, yeah, they're not necessarily the most reliable car, which is why, you know, I would love to have them here in Forza, because I'm not going to buy one of these just knowing the history of them, and I think that being able to drive it here in Forza would be an absolute blast. Coming in at number four, what we have is the 2016 Acura TLX. Now, this is just before they went ahead and did their facelift. I'm not necessarily a big fan of that huge grille, but at the same time, I could get used to it. I could get used to it. I like the 2016 because it's a little bit more subtle looking. It really is. I feel like with the 2017 Plus, it's really out there in your face, and I don't see very many of them. So I'm really not going to go with the with it being like an everyday car. Now, I'm sure that there are plenty of them out there. I just don't see them because I live in a rural area, so they're not very common down here. In fact, we don't even have a Honda dealership. We got a Toyota dealership, and then we got a Chevy dealership. That's all we got for like 60 miles. It's absolutely crazy. But the TLX was actually used in racing in the form of the TLX GT. It didn't necessarily do very well. I think the best place it got was like 13th in a race, and then it was very quickly replaced by the NSX because this was just before the NSX came out. But the one cool thing with the TLX, though, is you could get in the SH all-wheel drive format, which honestly, finally, we needed some all-wheel drive Hondas. I know I said this isn't Acura, but you know, Acura is basically a Honda. Throw this fucker into the Honda Civic Type R. Like, seriously, if we could get the Civic Type R with all-wheel drive, that would be absolutely amazing. Do you know how many of those they would sell? Like, goddamn, like, they're selling hotcakes. They're, like, selling, like, hotcakes here in the U.S., and they're front-wheel drive. Imagine throwing an all-wheel drive system in there with the same looks as they have now. Oh, my God, that thing would be absolutely amazing. But the other thing with the Acura TLX is it was lighter than the previous generation TL, because they actually moved from the TL, they scrapped that, and then they created the TLX. Although, to be honest, they didn't really change all that much in terms of looks, but it also had 290 horsepower with that all-wheel drive system. That is pretty damn awesome. It's actually got me looking into these as a possible car because they're not super expensive either. They are not that expensive. I think with like the 2016, I mean, you're going to be paying a little bit more for it. But if you go with like the TL, which I believe also had all-wheel drive, you know, you can get these things relatively inexpensive. And that's awesome. That is absolutely fantastic. I've looked into possibly getting one, but not a whole lot of aftermarket parts for it, which has kind of been my turnoff on that. Coming in at number three, what we have is the 2020 Nissan Maxima. Now, this has been actually going on for a while. I mean, you could go back a few years and you still have this. It was actually revealed during a Super Bowl, which is pretty interesting there. But I always felt like the Maxima, the newest generation, when it first kind of like got launched, I thought, man, that is aggressive looking for a Nissan sedan. Like, it looks mean, it looks angry. The previous generation had all these curves on it, and they tried to throw some aggression in it with the headlights, but overall, like, this car, it just changed the game for Nissan. Like, this was, like, before Nissan was a very roundy boy, it still looked like the old Infinities, like the G35s and the G37s, and then all of a sudden, boom! Here comes this Nissan Maxima out of the box, just changes up everything. Absolutely amazing. It's still a front-wheel drive car, though, so it doesn't get the all-wheel drive like, you know, the Acura does. So that is the one thing going for it there that's kind of messed up. But it does have 300 horsepower! It's 300 horsepower in a front-wheel drive car! That is so much! Like, I feel like that is just barely pushing the edge there, because don't they say, like, it's 300 horsepower for front-wheel drive is really about the limit that you want to go on that? Because otherwise, you are just going to get so much understeer. You're going to get so much torque steer. It's absolutely crazy. But because of that 300 horsepower, it has a 0 to 60 time in just 5.9 seconds. And that's pretty damn good. That is pretty dang good for a front-wheel drive everyday sedan that literally anybody can go pick up and buy. But I feel like if you were going to try and do that, your car is probably going to go either right or left. I don't know which direction the torque steer decides to go on these things, but it's going to go one way if you try and put the hammer down. And that can be fun sometimes, but also at other times, like if you are unexperienced in this and you're just trying to get onto the freeway, ooh, that's going to be a little bit scary, a little bit butt pucker in there. Coming in at number two, what we have is the 2020 Toyota Camry TRD. Now, I don't know if they actually decided to build the TRD model. I don't believe they did. But the TRD one over the regular Camry has decreased body roll, bigger brakes, upgraded suspension, bigger wheels, and an aggressive aero package. The only thing that it doesn't really get on top of all of that is more horsepower. It still has the same 3.5 liter V6 putting out 301 horsepower. But the reason why I'm going with the 2020 model, that is because for the first time ever, the Toyota Camry has all-wheel drive. And it's just like, boom. Like, before you could get like a sporty Camry, you could get like the V6 in there, but really that's all you're getting. It's a little bit more horsepower. It's still front-wheel drive. That's what it had. But finally in 2020, they're throwing an all-wheel drive system into it, and that changes everything. Because now you can have a 301 horsepower Camry that could be competing with the likes of the Ford Focus RS, you know, the Subaru WRX, all these other cars. Finally, Toyota has something to compete with, because up until now, really, if you wanted to buy a sporty Toyota, your options were either going to be an off-road vehicle like the Tacoma, the Tundra, or the 4Runner, or you, of course, had the 86, or also the Scion FRS, or technically also the Subaru PRZ, but that's, I'm talking about competitors to the WRX here. You know, you had to choose between whether or not you want an all-wheel drive sedan that's amazingly quick, or if you wanted this rear-wheel drive, sporty, fun car. That's really what it is. But now, Toyota comes out with the new 2020 Camry with all-wheel drive, and it looks aggressive. Like, this thing looks mean. And, I mean, everybody's been talking like the Camry definitely beats the Honda Accord in the looks department, although that's debatable there, too. I kind of like the Accord myself, but we're not even going to talk about the Accord on this list. But the thing is, though, the Camry TRD is just, honestly, a beautiful piece of art. I'm so glad that they finally went ahead and did something like this. but I want them to build it because I don't think they've actually decided on building it. But, you know, up until now, you could probably go ahead and get those parts and make it yourself. You could go out and you could buy a 2020 Camry with the V6 because, like I said earlier, it doesn't get any more horsepower. Get the all-wheel drive option and then just start modding the fuck out of it so that you have lower suspension, the bigger wheels, the bigger brakes, all that sort of stuff. And you're golden. You're golden. Then finally coming in at number one, I think that this one might surprise you guys. It is the 2013 Lincoln MKZ. Now, basically, this is a Ford Mondeo or a Ford Fusion for those of us here in the United States. Everywhere else, it's the Mondeo. But the thing is about this car is a lot of people always thought, man, that's kind of ugly. And I always thought, that's kind of cool looking. Like, I've actually looked into possibly buying one of these because they're pretty cheap nowadays. And basically, since it's the Ford Fusion, all the parts are relatively available. I mean, they sold hundreds of thousands of these cars all across the world. You know, the Mondeo over in Europe, we have the Fusion here, and then you have the Lincoln MKZ as well as a secondary option for those of us who want to be a little bit Porsche. And the thing is, though, I always like the headlights on these specifically. Like, they just kind of wing out a little bit. I always liked that. And that's what a lot of people didn't like, and then they moved on and they facelifted it, and I'm like, ugh. Facelift is kind of ugly now, but a lot of people seem to like the facelift better, so I guess it's just going to stick that way. But this car does have all-wheel drive as well, which was probably one of the other reasons that I really liked it, from a 3.7 liter, probably the biggest displacement motor out of this entire list, but it still only puts out 300 horsepower, which is one horsepower shy than the Toyota Camry. And honestly, I will say, I put these cars in just a random order. I honestly think if I had to actually pick my favorite one out of here, I'd probably go with the Camry. I really, really would, because it's got that Toyota reliability, and if I could get the TRD package on it, holy shit, that would be absolutely amazing. Now, the other thing I will say is I said this is boring everyday sedans, and that's really kind of what I was going for, but all the figures on here, I went with their max power and their max packages, so that's the other thing. I'm talking like 300 horsepower and all that sort of stuff. Well, you can also get them in four-cylinder options with front-wheel drive. All the all-wheel drive options have a front-wheel drive option as well. So these are all the max packages, and that's really kind of what I would like to see come to Forza. Because honestly, I think there would be a lot of people who would be interested in, you know, having those max packages. As most people, they're going to probably upgrade the front-wheel drive system to an all-wheel drive system or a rear-wheel drive system as it is anyway. So that's kind of what I was going for here. I know some people will be like, those aren't everyday, those are the sport versions. And it's like, we can't have every single model, my dudes. We can't have, like, you know, the 2012 Kia Optima LX, EX, SE, or what, I don't know what kind of models they actually have, but I decided to go ahead and throw in their max packages. That's kind of what I went for here. So anyway, though, that's where we're gonna wrap things up for today. Leave a comment down below. Let me know which one of these cars is your favorite, and do you have any other suggestions of cars that you would like to see? As I am taking suggestions, and maybe I will do a one of your guys' suggestions videos. Like that might be a good idea. That might be a good idea for sometime later on in the future. But like I said, that's where we're wrapping things up for today. If you want to, you can go ahead and follow me on Twitter and Instagram at twitter.com/GRF13 and instagram.com/GRF13. And if you like this video, go and make sure to hit that like button down below for us, because you guys already know your support is so greatly appreciated. And make sure to subscribe for more videos coming out all the time. Thank you guys so much for watching. Peace out. Bye.